This is child abuse. That's it. The cruelty is the point. I'm really just having a hard time here because the stereotyping and the criminalizing and the vilifying of the poor. Being poor is not a character flaw. There but for the grace of God go all of us. A hardship does not discriminate. It is transcendent. And I'm so tired of my colleagues on the other side. We had a hearing in another committee about student debt and the impact of this $1.6 trillion crisis on credit reports. And in that hearing, they made assumptions about, well, if you can't afford it, then just don't take out the loans. When we have veterans who are defaulting on student loans because of multiple deployments. Stop stereotyping who is struggling. Because under this administration, more people are struggling than ever before. Because Donald J. Trump, if nothing else, is an equal opportunity offender and abuser. This is child abuse. That's it. The cruelty is the point. And so far as I'm concerned, this administration has blood on their hands because of the humanitarian crisis at the border, because of money that has been allocated but not released to Puerto Rico, because of the scourge of public health, the public health crisis and violence, that is gun violence that they refuse to act on, and now starving children. So many outright lies and baseless claims I can barely keep up. But he has the nerve to then evoke God and faith and to express a newfound interest in ensuring, quote, that every baby has the best chance to thrive and grow, unquote. And to remind us, quote, that every human life is a sacred gift from God, unquote. Well, the autoimmune disease alopecia universalis has robbed me of my hair. But it has not robbed me of my memory, and I spent plenty of time in Sunday school. In Matthew 25, 35, this administration has forgotten about the least of these. So this is an ironic assertion to come from this administration. Putting more than 3 million individuals, pushing them off of SNAP, including more than 1 million children. In Massachusetts, more than 100,000 people stand to lose access to benefits, including 72,000 children. It's very apropos during this time of year to quote Dr. King, but who doesn't get quoted enough is Coretta. She said, starving a child is violence. Punishing a mother and her family is violence. And consent for poverty is violence. Let me be clear, this administration's attack on SNAP is nothing more than violence waged on the most vulnerable among us, our children, the elderly, individuals with disabilities, the poor, and the sick.